Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be running you through this really dark, deep, sort of smoky brown eye. I've had a lot of requests from you guys to show you an actual brown smoky eye. A lot of you are saying that most smoky eye tutorials you've come across are either, you know, full black or gray, or they involve a bunch of colors. And I know a lot of you are wanting to create something with bronzes and browns and like those more neutral tones. So yes, that's pretty much what today's video is going to be about. We're purely going to focus on the eyes. And I'm going to be running you guys through a bunch of blending tips that I would use to create like the most, you know, like just perfect smoldering bronze brown smoky eye. So if you are interested in learning how to create this, then please keep on watching. So I hate to beat a dead horse, but it really is super important that you actually prime the surface that you're going to be blending on. I know that I talk about this all the time, but yeah, I just really cannot stress the importance. It will make your shadows brighter, it will make them blend easier, and it will also make sure that they last all day long without creasing and just going all gross. As always, my fave is the MAC Pro Longwear Paint Put in the color Soft Ochre. It's just like by far the absolute best eye base out there. Now for the actual eyeshadow palette, I'm going to be using the Morphe 35G Bronze Goals palette. You don't have to use this one specifically, you just need something with a whole bunch of different brown options in it. Now to get started, what I want you to do is to take a really red undertone brown and then a cool undertone brown. I know that sounds bizarre, but I want you to mix both of those shadows on a sort of small to medium sized blending brush, and we're going to start laying this down as our initial blend. Mixing the two undertones of shadows will make it easier to blend, because different shadows of different color undertones and different tones, they actually have different size pigments in them. And then, you know, when you've got small, medium and large pigments all through the mixture, it makes it a hell of a lot easier to blend. Now what I want you to do is to take that on, like I said, a medium or small to medium blending brush, and I want you to start to really focus that one through the crease, so working inwards and outwards through the line of the crease. When you get to the inner corner of the eye, I want you to look outwards towards your ear, continue to buff and blend that shadow inwards towards your nose, just really taking a whole lot of time to make sure that's super smooth and seamless. Don't take it too far up onto the brow bone. Really, really keep it nice and tight and focused on the eye there. Now, another cool tip for blending is, if you are having trouble, take a bronzer on a larger fluffy blending brush and buff that on the outer part of the eyeshadow. It will make it a whole lot easier to blend. Bronzers are really, really fantastic. And yes, I'm talking about straight up bronzers that you use on your face. Now we're starting to get a bit deeper and darker. I want you to take a slightly darker brown eyeshadow on a small pencil brush, and I want you to start to really, really focus this on the fold of your crease of your eye. Now, why I'm recommending using such a small brush is because with, you know, blending with a smoky eye, it's very, very easy to accidentally blend the darker colors up too high, and that's what causes that kind of like punched in the eye sort of a look. It's really important to have a really layered gradient effect, so deepest, darkest color on the lid, medium sort of a color, and then building up to lighter color outwards. So apply it with that pencil brush really tight in the crease, and then take that brush that you used originally with no additional shadow, buff out the edges, and pretty much repeat. You want to repeat backwards and forwards between these two steps a bunch of times to make sure that that line between that deep dark shadow that's really deep in that socket in that crease there, you want to make sure that there's no, you know, choppiness, and that those two lines blend out seamlessly together. Now for the lid, this is where your deepest, darkest shade is going to go, but first you want to frame that area. So taking another very small pencil brush, I'm pretty much repeating the last step. So I'm packing that directly. I'm actually sort of angling the brush upwards, as you can see, so that the top bristles really don't come too much into contact with the fold of my crease there. And this keeps that really deep, 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 dark chocolate color really, really based on the lid only. Don't worry about what's going on the actual lid yet. We'll deal with that later. We're really focusing on that line above the crease that fades upwards and outwards. So again, taking that brush that I started out with originally, buffing out the edges and repeating the steps until I am happy with the blend. It's so important. Like, I cannot stress how important it is to repeat these steps over and over. And like I said, if you're struggling to get it to blend on the inner corner, look outwards towards your ear with your eye, and you'll be able to get it really nice and tight in towards the nose there. So applying that color, being really careful to keep it in the crease, and then coming back and blending with that original brush. Okay, moving on to the lower lash line. It's a bit odd, but I do the lower lash line opposite to the top lid when I'm doing a deep, dark, smoky eye like this. I actually apply the darkest color color first, really, really nice and tight and super close to the lash line with a very small brush. I'll then come in with another brush. I will apply the medium blending shade, you know, that we actually applied first, and then I'll sort of buff that over the edge, continuing to smoke it out. And then lastly, I will finish with an either light brown eyeshadow or a bronzer. I really recommend using a bronzer. They just blend and buff everything out so perfectly because they're not super, super high pigment like eyeshadows are. It's a really, really good tip if you're trying to get something to blend. Try using a bronzer instead. It will literally change your life. But yeah, the lower lash line, it's important for it to be super, super smoky as well. Otherwise, it will look messy later on. Then finally, you want to start laying down your color on the lid. So you can go for a really dark color like this. Pack it on. Now, because we've already really outlined and framed that crease area, it's going to blend seamlessly upwards and outwards into that blending that we already did. And I always like to add a shimmer. It just makes things really special, and it also sort of softens the entire look on the eyes. When I want a smoky eye, like I want it to be like, oh wow, that's a smoky eye, but I still want it to look soft and feminine, and adding a shimmer onto the lid actually really, really helps. So I'm just patting it on with a finger. If you blink a couple of times, it will sort of blend itself in to the crease, or you can come in with a brush and blend it a little bit further, but it just really softens up the whole look. So just a shimmer that matches, you know, the color tones that you've used to do the blend, that's what will work perfectly. Now, I'm a huge fan of highlighting the brow bone. It lifts the eye, it opens the eye, it brightens the eye, it'll help your eyes not look so closed in. Smoky eyes can have the tendency to sort of make your eyes look a little bit closed in, but lifting the brow bone with a highlight will really dramatically affect this. You'll just look good, like super, super wide and awake, and it helps, you know, if you've got hooded eyes or anything like that, or if the tops of your eyelids are sort of starting to sag, it will really help to sort of lift and open everything up. And I also like to pop a highlight on the inner corner of the eye as well, again to open, brighten and lift the eye. Now we want a tight line. So tight lining is applying eyeliner pretty much in between your lashes, right on the lash line. You can do a wing if you want, but for smoky eyes like this, I like the focus really to be on how beautiful and smoky and, you know, how it sort of fades out into the skin, into nothing. So I like to tight line. So pretty much just a liquid eyeliner. This one's from Benefit. I have been loving this one lately. Just wiggling it in between the lashes and getting it nice and close there to make that all nice and dark. And then applying a couple of coats of mascara. Really loving this one, guys. This is a Smashbox Superfan mascara. Yeah, she's totally, totally, totally smudge proof. I've been really enjoying it. So I'm applying a couple of coats of mascara on both my top and lower lashes. You can stop it there if you want, but you guys know me, I am a false lash junkie, so I'm going to be going in with some lashes. We actually have launched two new 3D luxury silk styles over on Nakia Joy Cosmetics, which I'm so excited about. So this style here is the Scarlet Lash. Really perfect for a smoky eye, super voluminous, but still really lightweight and perfectly safe for sensitive and small eyes. So this is one of our new styles. Oh, I'm so proud of them. They're so pretty. And then the second new style that we have launched is the Jasmine Lash. As you can see, this one's a little bit more structured, really beautiful and fans out on the edge to help elongate the eye. You know, both of these are available right now on our website, and you can use the code Nakia to get 15% off if you are interested. And we do also ship worldwide for free with any purchase over $40. So I'm applying our new Scarlet Lash. It's just so perfect for smoky eyes or for anything. Not like, I mean, kind of dramatic, but not super, super dramatic. Like I said, they're still beautiful and like perfectly safe for smaller eyes. And look how much that transforms that smoky eye. Like it completely takes it to the next level. A couple of quick tips before we finish up this video today, guys. When you are doing a smoky eye, it's really important to add some color to your face. And also, I like to add a little bit of shimmer or shine to the face. It just softens the overall look. It stops the smoky eye from looking, you know, like too harsh. Just really, you know, softens everything up. And then I do also like to pair it with kind of like an understated lip, whether that be a nude, a brown, a pink, whatever it is. You know, you choose whatever you like. And then lastly, set everything down really well with a setting spray. You guys know how much I'm obsessed with the Gerard Cosmetics Slay All Day. Absolute best setting spray out there. If you do want to get this one, you can get two full sizes for the price of one with the code JOYBOGO. So that's pretty much it, guys. I hope today's video helped. I hope the blending tips helped. If you do have any more questions about, you know, smoky eyes for beginners, please be sure to pop them in the comment section down below. I'll be hanging out down there answering those questions for you. And yes, I love you all so, so much. I will catch you guys in my next video.